Hello guys, I will show you today a few things about Blender and the use of Xplane2Blender add-on, how to install and how to use it. First of all, to install the add-on, we are downloaded from the Xplane2Blender GitHub repository. I will have the link in the description, and we'll go file and then user preferences. And then we go install from file, and we'll go through the here and find it, and explain the Blender, find the version. This one here, and click install. I have already installed, so I'm not going to do that now. Also, and then you, if we go here, you can see here it's Xplane2Blender. We tick it, make it sure it's checked, and then save user settings. So every time we load the Blender, it's enabled. In case that you cannot install it using this method, then we can go to the we have it here, we have a zip file, we have a zip, and there is this folder here, IO explained to Blender. We copy this folder to our Blender. Here is for Mac, so you may have some different layout, but in Blender folder you will find the version number, script, add-on, and then we paste it here, and that is good to go. Now when we load Blender, if you come here to the file export menu, you can see here it says explain to explain object. Take a notice that there's two kinds .obj exporters. One is from Xplane, that one we're going to use, and the other is Wavefront obj, which is the most common file for 3D usage. But this is not working. This is the one we work in Xplane. Now, if we come here to Scene tab, here on the bottom we can see the Xplane dialog. There's a lot of other dialogues. Here is the Xplane dialog. For the first time here, it might say add Xplane layers. You click it and it will expand, and you get this one here. So if we want to export an object in Fur, which is this every here box represents a layer in Blender. If we expand here, we can see some things we must know about it. Here is we enter the name of the object, for example box, and here the type. If it's a scenery object, which will be repeated many times, we select instant scenery object, like a car, like something that will use it many times in Xplane. If it's a scenery object that will not be used many times, like a terminal building, like a hangar, then we select scenery object. For aircrafts, if it's any part of the aircraft, we use aircraft part. If it's the cockpit object, this is specific for aircraft development, then we use this one here. Here says auto detect textures, and this is read the textures you have set in the material. But usually I prefer to uncheck this and manually Type here the names, for example, box PNG. I feel more comfortable for the result here. Also, if you want to use level of details, you can set here the level of details, and then you can set the near and the far for each one of this. Scenery objects here, if we're going to use some groups for the object, for example, let's say marking, and we set the offset negative, positive as we like. Some slope properties, if we want the object to be tilted, or in what limit we set for the slope. Here you set the different options. If required, wet, dry, or any surface. This has to add weight to an object that is attached to an aircraft, but I'm not sure that it's working 100%. And there's some other advanced ops, here some export path directives, and custom properties if you want to set a special custom property. What else is very important for Xplane? Of course, if we want to go to the here again to this scene tab, I'm always set here the metrics. So if I go, for example, here and select let's say this edge, I can come here and check and have the length displayed. So when I'm modeling or doing something, I have an idea what the actual dimensions are. Now in the excuse me, object panel, here we can set any data if you want to do any animation or a manipulation. It's a cockpit object. If we come here to the material tab, we set here material. Every object must have a material to be exported, otherwise it won't be exported. And down here there are some other options for Xplane. If you want to use, you can also drag it for example here, so and then save the startup file, so you can have it directly. You don't have to scroll down. Now this is there are some options here. If you hover with the mouse, you will get some explanation about this. One important thing is if we want normal metalness to be used in our object, then we need to check here. Also here we'll check if it's an aircraft, if it's a glass, to blend glass, or the alpha cutoff value. If there's something like a trick which is semi-transparent, so we don't have any transparency issues. Also, again here we can set the surface behavior. If it's an object that the camera cannot go through, camera collision. If you want to override light levels for this object, for example, usually this is used in aircrafts when you want something like a panel with letters, to use something, a data ref to change of the texture. Also, if this is an op if this is a cockpit object, and this one special object must be used to display the panel of the aircraft, and I mean the cockpit panels that you display the instruments, then we must check this here, that is part of the cockpit panel, and then we can go and map it to the plane maker panel and have the displayed objects here, displayed in Xplane. This is most of the things. If you have any questions, please ask. I can make more tutorials if you need to explain some things. Last thing, to avoid going many times here to export the object, etc., you can add a shortcut to do that. To do this, go to User Preferences, Input, and go 3D View, 3D View Global, and scroll down here to the end. Okay, as you see here, if we'll click Add a New, Add a New dialog. So the one now, and then I will write export dot explain dash underline excuse me obj, and then I will click here to set a key, and then some other keys. So when I will press in the 3D viewport code, excuse me, was it? I forgot the shortcut now. come on. Shift Command. Where for Max? Shift Command and E. I will get directly to export OBJ object with a shortcut. That's for now, guys. If you need more tutorials, please tell me so. Whenever I have time, I will do more. Bye bye for now.